another chapter of Chainsaw Man doing what Chainsaw Man does, and that's completely surprise everybody and entirely divert what your like thoughts are about to happen. It's been such a strange series. I think it's always been set to be a strange series, and I don't think anybody's ever going to get to a point where they're like, yeah, I think we figured Chainsaw Man out. I mean, to a degree of like, yeah, there's going to be a lot of like gore and action and a lot of depression, but for the most part, this story, good luck trying to guess and figure out what's happening. So, as it were, we got a nice color page for Aki at the start of this, and people are pointing out how prior, like anytime someone gets one of these color pages where it's them kind of just peacefully standing around, it's led to their death. You know, we had one with Reza, and we had one for Himeno. So I'm worried. I don't want Aki to die, but I'll talk about my theory on this and where I think it'll round out, because it's with an old theory that I've had that I've mentioned about my belief on Aki's fate, but also where I would believe for it to make sense, as well as for where the story will lead to. I might actually have an idea of like where Chainsaw Man might go soon. Essentially, the chapter starts out, you have Denji, Power, and Aki just all like sleeping next to each other. Looks like they just had a fun time hanging out, and Aki's just like happy looking at him, and I think it's just the fact that he's now found something in life really to enjoy. He's found people he cares about, found people that he can get along with, and that being the reason he like wanted to pull the group out of the Gun Devil Hunt. I think it's just really nice, because up through the series, we saw that he was wanting to go to the Gun Devil. He wanted to take down the Gun Devil and deal with the Gun Devil because of the fact that he's like, I have nothing else to live for. Revenge and, you know, stopping this from ever happening again is pretty much what he wanted. But after he realized, like, that he does have, like, stuff in his life now again, even though his family was killed, he's kind of, you know, got this newer one with Power and Denji and can't forget Meowie, but it's... At this point, he seems to just want to, like, live his life and enjoy what time he has left. At that point, they're called in, like, to the Devil Hunting Headquarters. You have Makima there, who's saying, like, oh, yeah, I got your message from Kishibe. So, we're going to take Division 4 out of the expedition for the Gun Devil, but I'm bringing Denji and Power anyway. So, this was obviously going to be a big turmoil point for him. And the only question for me was going to be whether or not Makima lets him back into the group if he asked for it. Because I knew he was going to ask. Because at this point, it's not, oh, well, I'm pulled out, I guess I'll just wait. It's, at this point, if they're going, he's going to want to go, because he's going to want to do what he can to keep them safe and to keep them just, you know, as the best they can be. And as well as, he doesn't want to abandon them. He doesn't want to just kind of, like, pull back for his own safety, which is good. And I imagine in Aki's mind that he knows that if they die during all this, he would want to die with them and, you know, or at least be around them. Because, you know, Denji's pretty much immortal, and Power is like a pseudo-immortal. She can just kind of, like, always heal up with blood and stuff. But, I mean, like, a lot of devils are like that. But obviously, she more than others for being a straight blood devil. But after the point, like, he just asks, he's like, all right, can I go anyway? And then she's like, yeah, cool, yeah, he can be the guardian for Denji and Power. We need him. We got to show the force of what these guys are capable of, and, you know, what this division's been doing. And then we get a reveal that was, again, like I said, Chainsaw Man being absolutely absurd and, like, its weirdness, reveals the Gun Devil has already been beaten and like, locked up. And essentially, what had happened was, after the first events of the Gun Devil, they sent somebody down. They don't say exactly who. They said taken down by somebody else. I'm wondering if maybe that somebody else is, like, gonna be, like, the top, like, character of the Devil Hunters. Maybe it's, like, the legend of the Devil Hunters. There's somebody beyond Kishibe. Maybe there's, like, you know, somebody that's so powerful they have to keep secret or something like that. Maybe it was Makima. Who knows? Either way, they beat the Gun Devil, and they split up his pieces. So, like, America has 20%, the Soviets have 28%, China has 11%, 4% is, like, split up by various countries, and then 37% is being held by just devils all around the world. As we saw, like, earlier with the Eternity Devil, you know, they take a fraction of the Gun Devil, then it makes them more powerful. They're essentially absorbing something beyond them to improve themselves. So, again, this is really interesting because everyone expected it to be like some big raid, you know, big shonen, like, oh, we got to go take this guy down. It's going to be a big epic battle. But it's more of the fact that this entire, like, very, very powerful being is being, like, harnessed kind of like their resources. It's like they're like the weapons of mass destruction. They're like nukes, but in this case, they're pieces of this extremely powerful devil. And I'm guessing it's the strongest devil that they've been able to kind of, like, actually take down and hold on to, because we know that there are the primal devils, like the primordial devils in hell, that have never died and come over, so obviously they would have never really dealt with them. But it, as far as we know, the gun devil is the strongest devil that has come over. We don't know if maybe there's other ones. Maybe the one that took down the gun devil is a more powerful devil that just kind of like is allied with one of these nations, who knows. But the fact they're using these as, like, a resource, and it's explained further of when they're talking about it, is because Aki's like, well, what about the guns that the guys that used, that group that killed Tomeno, like, had, like, and instead of it being, like, guns from the gun devil, they were man-made, and essentially, like, there are people, like, making guns within the government, like, the different countries, even though they have a bunch of rules that they have in place for manufacturing and distribution of guns, because of, you know, obviously, the gun devil is such a, like, wide-known feared thing, in that they want to keep, like, the fear of guns as much as down as they possibly can, because of the fact that it'll make the gun devil stronger. And she's essentially, like, explaining, they keep doing that, and they'll have them kind of, like, spread out, so people will stay afraid of guns. And that way, like, these, like, resources are always getting stronger. They're always, like, viable, and they're always kind of, like, useful. They're always something that they have at their disposal, which, again, is really interesting. And Aki's even like, this sounds like a very strange conspiracy theory. Like, this is weird. But it's all laying out for, again, a really interesting, like, story piece. And instead of it being, oh, we're going to go and, you know, fight the gun devil and we're going to track him down and it's going to be like a big battle, it's going to be more like a war. It's going to be like a fight for resources. It's going to be like the top characters from each of these nations probably going at it and trying to raid them in order to get the pieces. So I'm guessing that in all this, it's going to have to do, or it's going to explain why the chainsaw is so important in all this. And so the gun devil is not really dead. At the same time, he's, like, just kind of, like, all cut up, so they probably are, like, keeping fractions of him in, like, jars or something. So I'm wondering who has the head, and I'm guessing it's going to be Russia, because we know Russia's got the majority of the pieces in one group. They have 28%, as well as we know that Himeno seemed to be allied with the gun devil, so I'm guessing that his head can still talk, and maybe, like, that's going to be, like, at what point that we see, like, him explain what's special about the chainsaw and what goes on with the chainsaw, and, like, where this is kind of, like, gonna work out. And I'm very curious to know, like, what Fujimoto is gonna do with this. Is it gonna be, like, they're gonna go to a different country, or are they gonna sneak in, and, like, what exactly is this gonna mean for, like, the characters when they get over there? Because we haven't left Japan. I'd actually like to see them go to other countries and see, like, what exactly it's like in these other zones. Because it's like a weird, like, in Chainsaw Man, as far as we've seen, it's just kind of like this weird constant state of fear that people are in, but they're used to it. And you got these guys all running around, like, trying to kill all these devils. But we know that other countries, like, have them, like, kind of, like, militarized. And I think it's going to be a really interesting way to see, like, how Fujimoto has this world kind of constructed around, like, what is normal for them. Because it's not like devils just appeared in their world and people are coping. Like, they've long since adapted, and it's, like, ingrained into, like, their societies and stuff. And I've mentioned that before. I've always really liked series when they'll take some weird concept, and it'll be such a staple in their own world that to the reader, it's like, this is really weird. But in their world, it's such a very, like, normal concept. It's kind of like in Yu-Gi-Oh, like once you get to like GX and 5Ds, and it's like these guys settle all their differences with cards, but at the same time, you're like, yeah, they've been doing this for years and years, so it in their world, it's just normal. It's not something they think that much about when they do it. It's just like, oh yeah, this is just a standard. Whereas like if you obviously if you look at that from the point of like the viewer and you have like no idea of like the structure of the world, you'd be like, that's kind of fucking weird. You think that they would settle this with bigger things. It's any series like that where it's got that that kind of like built-in structural tone of just like how the people in the world have gotten used to it. I've always really liked that when series do it. But then Aki has like a vision of the future, and then like later that night afterwards, he's like talking to the future devil, and he's like, you know, listen, I need you to tell me like what exactly you showed me. And he's like, you and Power are going to be slaughtered by Denji, and after that, the devil that the devils fear most shall appear. So, where I'm guessing with that, because I talked about at the start of this that I had an idea of where this is going to go and how I think that this is going to like move into the next story arc. So I've talked about before, I don't think Aki is going to die because the characters in Chainsaw Man, they get a lot of them get killed out of nowhere. Like though an event will happen, there's a lot of them that will just kind of like get killed and care like a lot of deaths in Chainsaw Man for a lot of characters, they're made out more of like if you were actually there to where like not every death is going to be some big heroic thing. Like something could just be like some dude just got caught up in something and gotten killed. And even though they're like not emphasized, it still can be like damn, that sucks. That's unfortunate. It gets to be some big thing. But that's just how it is. Like I think the realistic kind of like portion on that is one of the things that makes Chainsaw Man stand out a little. But then you still get those character deaths that are obviously like way more emphasized, something like Kamano that was way more emotional, way more focused on like the singular character and whatnot. But Aki's is a character who is constantly brought up the fact that he's constantly getting screwed over. He's only got one arm now. His lifespan keeps decreasing and decreasing, and he's now in a situation where they're like, yeah, you're gonna die for sure. We already knew that beforehand when he got the Future Devil that he's like, you're gonna die in the worst possible way. I think that Aki's like constant, like you're gonna die, you're gonna die, you're gonna die. It's all kind of like a almost like a misdirection sort of, because when these other characters like they'll just die, and then the Aki's like the only guy living, but the only character who's constantly emphasized how he's gonna die. I think he's gonna die in a sort, but more of like who he was. I think he's gonna end up becoming a hybrid kind of like Denji, and in the process of like of that, Denji's gonna have to kill him. Because keep this in mind. If keep this one, Denji could kill Power right now. He could like literally get up, chainsaw up, cut her in half, like and mutilate her. She won't really die. She'll just go back to hell. But if Aki is like a because yeah, she'll never really die. Like Beam, and like Violence, they're sort of dead. We don't know like what it will be like if they return because their memories. We know their memories kind of get a little messed up. They have like fractions of it for the most part. They don't seem to remember everything. Maybe there'll be a way around that in the future, but yeah, they could come back sort of different, and maybe they won't be the same character, but they'll be from the same origin. But they never truly die. The devils never truly die. They just can be kind of altered. Whereas, like, imagine if later in this arc, like they get killed, go back to hell. And then Aki, because he becomes some form of hybrid, he goes to hell, and we get like an arc inside of hell, and we see what like it's like there. Because we saw a little bit of it with like you know when they got sucked in by the Hell Devil, but the hell has to have like its own kind of like civilization. You know, maybe like it's got like almost like towns. Maybe they have their own like kind of like settlements and structures. I just am like kind of like imagining like this Mad Max kind of post-apocalyptic world. And I think it would be really cool to see at that point going in, because we can only get so much out of the world with the series that I think it will eventually kind of just feel way more modern, but like with the devil aspects and you know maybe some form of like power struggle and stuff between other countries. We gotta keep this in mind. This is Chainsaw Man, and the second things start to get a little settling, you know that that's when things are about to get the craziest. You know that things are about to get absolutely absurd, and there's no like time of like, all right, I'm comfortable with this. I'm used to like what's going on right here. Let's get in the good vibes of like, oh yeah, we're gonna do an arc where all these assassins are gonna come after Denji. Nope, you're gonna go to hell and confront some primordial devil of the dark and stuff. So I think something like that, like a hell arc, Or maybe we could find out more about, like, just being in hell. We can find out more about, like, the origins of some of the devils. See, like, how just some of them, like, live their lives when they're not in, when they're not out in the human world. And on top of that, when they say, like, the devil that the devils fear most shall appear, I'm guessing that's going to have to do with Pochita. I'm guessing that's going to have to do with, like, essentially the fear around the chainsaw. Because we know that that there's, like, this, like, small rooted memory from the angel devil that they remembered the sound of Denji's chainsaw engine. And obviously, that coming from Pochita. We know that the chainsaw has some form of higher-end significance, but we haven't gotten to it yet. So I'm guessing that it'll be, like, maybe Denji will open the door and we'll actually see what that version looks like. And we could get something like kind of like, you know, back when Naruto would lose control of the nine-tailed fox, and it would be kind of this berserker. Because Denji still has, like, he's kind of fuzzy in his head when he goes into his chainsaw form. He's still able to kind of, like, talk and obviously be, you know, form and, you know, and ideas and stuff, but he's not clearly himself. He's like, I'm a little bit deranged. Whereas if we could see, like, maybe, like, a berserk form where he's, like, bigger, maybe there's more chainsaws and stuff. It's just kind of like this more nightmare fuel version where he has, like, no reason, no control, and he's just, like, this giant slaughter machine for a while. And we could see what exactly makes the chainsaw so special. And then maybe, like, use that to, like, have him fight, like, some big character. Maybe the gun devil will come back in full aspect, or we'll see a different primordial devil, something like that. Because the chainsaw clearly is a big deal. The chainsaw is clearly a big deal, and we just got to figure out what exactly it is. So I think it was a really interesting setup, and even in something like the idea, like, it's like, oh, well, Power can't really die, sort of, and I'm not sure that Aki will die. It's not like one of those ones where it's like, you know, the author is not really going to kill him off. You know, a lot of, you know, could be a fake out death. Personally, I'm fine with fake out deaths as long as, like, some character, like, important plot stuff, like, is moved with it. Like, you know, you get more content than just, like, a character dying. You get more of, like, progress for, like, stuff to happen. But with Chainsaw Man, it's more of like, what weird thing is he going to do in order, and with this, like, what weird ass thing is Fujimoto going to do for the construction of this whole layout of what's to come? But anyway, other than that, comment below. Tell me your thoughts are about this chapter, and tell me your thoughts about what's coming up. I'm pretty hyped. I definitely think this is going to get really weird. And I would love to have something again like a Hell Arc, or see like a Berserk Denji. And Denji already is kind of like, he's sort of berserk, but I want, like, a full, uncontrolled, like, just monster, like, chainsaw kaiju-looking guy. But anyway, other than that, comment below. Thumbs up the video from the like button, subscribe button, and check out my other videos. But other than that, I appreciate everyone who's already subscribed, and I thank you all for listening. Bye.